Hello everyone. Today I'll be discussing you ABG, that is arterial blood gas analysis, commonly used investigations in clinical practice. But any investigation will never confirm the problem what patient is having. Always clinical correlation is required. But investigation always helps to quantify the problem patient is having. So how much problem patient is having now, later how much problem is patient is having, whether problem is deteriorating, whether values are increasing, decreasing. According to that you can decide the treatment accordingly. I'll be discussing introduction, clinical indications, steps for analysis of ABG. Normally we get the parameters in ABG like pH, PaCO2, PaO2, SaO2, base excess, HCO3 minus levels. These are the normal common parameters we get in ABG. So pH shows you acid base balance of the blood, arterial blood, and PaCO2, PaO2 shows you gaseous exchange, in how much gas oxygenation and carbon dioxide level in the arterial blood. Now commonly for ABG, arterial blood is taken for the analysis. Common arteries are radial artery, because most superficial and most convenient place to be taken. So radial artery is commonly taken. Other than that, dorsalis pedis artery or brachial artery or femoral arteries are also common places from where arterial blood sample is taken. Why venous blood is not taken for the analysis and why arterial blood is taken for the analysis? The reason is physiology behind that. That is, gaseous exchange occurs at the lung and capillary membrane level, and from there oxygenated blood, whatever gaseous exchange has occurred from the lungs, that blood will go to left side of the heart, and from there it will go to the arterial system. So now that arterial blood sample will give you the analysis of the gaseous exchange, has whatever has occurred by the lungs, respiratory system. So you can analyze the function of respiratory system through that gaseous exchange. So arterial blood sample is taken. And why not venous blood? The reason is venous blood, always arterial blood goes through the tissues where the gaseous exchange again occurs, tissue membrane, and there venous blood is mixed with the whatever waste metabolites and oxygenation is, carbon dioxide waste metabolites are exchanged and that is changed. So venous blood is not taken as a sample. So now you will be able to understand what we analyze through ABG. Two major things we analyze through ABG is, one is acid base balance of blood, which is optimal, which should be optimal for the cellular level function. 7.35 to 7.45 is optimal level of pH in the arterial blood. And one more thing we analyze through this is whether we can differentiate respiratory system is at fault for the body, or else renal system, that is metabolic system, is at fault. So lungs' ability to oxygenate the blood and remove excess of CO2, that respiratory system function is also analyzed through ABG. So finally, arterial blood gas analysis is the investigation which analyzes major two things. One is acid base balance of the blood, and another one is lungs' ability to oxygenate blood and remove excess of carbon dioxide. Now, clinical findings indicating need of ABG. That is, when ABG is indicated, when there is a need of ABG, there are some certain symptoms which indicates ABG need. Those are acute dyspnea, that is severe breathlessness, acute chest pain, cough, fever, sputum. These are the respiratory symptoms where cough, fever, sputum production consistent with pneumonia or symptoms of blurred vision and headache consistent with carbon monoxide poisoning. These are the indications or symptoms when ABG will be indicated. The reason is how much of affection in the function of the lungs is present to quantify that it is needed, or else to rule out whether acute dyspnea, what is the cause for dyspnea, whether cardiac cause is there, whether respiratory cause is there, whether any other cause is there, to rule out how much affection in the lungs gaseous exchange, that you will be able to quantify through ABG. Next is past medical history. For example, history, all these respiratory known cases where patient is having history of COPD or cystic fibrosis or pulmonary fibrosis or any other cases, like patient is having long-term exposure of environmental dust, or a patient is meal worker where continuous exposure of harmful chemicals are there and that is known to harm the lungs, where gaseous exchange may get affected today or years later. So that has to be investigated. History of diabetes with ketoacidosis, where metabolic issues will be there. Your renal system, diabetes is known to cause nephropathy complication. So that may decrease the functions of renal system, and that is very, very important. Renal and respiratory, both the systems are very, very necessary to maintain normal pH level in the blood. So any of these systems are not working, any of the system is not working, then it will cause imbalance in the pH. So history of diabetes with ketoacidosis, we may have to check pH level in the blood with any complications. So significant smoking history also may need your if it is complicated, then you may have to go for again ABG may be needed. Physical examination, the signs like cyanosis, where cyanosis is known to occur due to respiratory cause also. Again, another peripheral cyanosis like tissue gaseous exchange issues may be there. So to know whether it is central cause or peripheral cause, cardiac cause, ruling out, it will be necessary. So diffuse crackers, these are all respiratory signs where you may have to go for investigation like ABG. The cyanosis, diffuse crackles and wheezing on auscultation, severe tachypnea, heavy use of accessory muscles, unexplained confusion, evidence of chest trauma, if any other signs are there with that. Not only single reason, two or multiple reasons are there, then you may have to go for ABG. Chest radiograph, these are the signs over the chest radiograph. So this shows, these are the signs which shows that there is some respiratory affection. But to quantify how much affection is there in gaseous exchange, whether it is there or not, or whether it is acceptable limits or not, to check that ABG will be indicated. So finally, uses of ABG. What are the uses of ABG? Arterial blood gas analysis assesses oxygenation. Most important thing, PaO2 will show you how much oxygenation is occurring in the arterial blood. Next, it assists in differentiating between respiratory and metabolic problems. For example, PaCO2 is a measure of respiratory system or ventilation. So if PaCO2 is disturbed, you may come to know about respiratory involvement is there or not, and metabolic issues are there, HCO3 minus level increase, decrease in certain out of range, then it shows you metabolic issues also. We can differentiate whether metabolic system has initiated the problem or else respiratory system has initiated the problem. We will come to know through ABG. So differentiation, that is important. To monitor improvement or deterioration, always ABG can be helpful. Any investigation will be helpful to monitor whether patient is getting deteriorated or improving through the values in the investigation. So that is also helpful. and to associate with history and clinical examination, you will be able to know always the patient's history, patient symptom, whether it is increasing, decreasing, what are the symptoms, why it is occurring. You can associate from ABG also, or any investigation. You can always confirm the diagnosis by correlating investigation, history and clinical symptoms of the patient. So acid base balance basics, this depends on two systems basically, respiratory as well as renal system. These are the major parameters you will be seeing in ABG: pH, that is H plus, ion concentration in the blood, PaCO2, that is P is pressure, CO2 is carbon dioxide, and small a suggests you, that is arterial blood. So pressure of carbon dioxide in arterial blood is PaCO2. Again, it is a measure of ventilation, because lungs are functioning to remove excess CO2 outside the lung, means outside the blood or body. So that will be seen when, if lungs are not functioning properly, CO2 will be increased in the blood. It will not be able to come out through lungs outside, so that will be increased. So PaCO2, PaO2 is measure of oxygenation or gaseous exchange. HCO3 minus is a base, it is a measure of metabolic disturbance. If that is increased or decreased, pH level will be changed. For example, PaCO2, if that is increased, CO2 level is increased, it will be mixed with H2O, it will make H2CO3, it will take the pH towards the acidosis. Whereas CO3 minus is a base, if that is increased in the blood, then it will cause pH to be near to alkalosis, towards alkalosis. Base excess is a measure of metabolic disturbance. These are the normal values. pH 7.35 to 7.45, it should be optimal. This range, it should remain in this range for cellular level functioning. pH is very, very important. To if pH is normal, then all the cellular level functions are occurring normally. If pH is going either acidosis or towards alkalosis, that is less than 7.35, that is acidosis, more than 7.45, that is alkalosis. If it is going beyond normal range, then it will always disturb the cellular level functions. So any bodies, any organ may be disturbed in its work because of pH disturbance. So either respiratory or renal system is malfunctioning, then it will cause disturbance in the pH level. PaCO2 normal value is 35 to 45 mmHg, that is pressure, so it is in mmHg. PaO2 80 to 100 mmHg, unit is mmHg, because it is a pressure in of oxygen in the arterial blood. HCO3 minus is again a base. 22 to 26 milli equivalent per liter is its unit, and base excess plus or minus 2. Base excess is nothing, but it shows whether base is added in your blood or base is lost from the blood. So if it is in plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, goes towards plus, then it shows base is added in the blood, whereas minus 3, minus 4, minus 2, it shows that it is lost from the blood because of any system, any reason. So that is base excess. And one more parameter you will get, that is SaO2, saturation of oxygen in the arterial blood. So that also is important. So these are the normal parameters you get in ABG. Thank you. Next part of ABG we will be covering in another video, because it is little lengthy to discuss everything in one video. So thank you for patient listening.